A 19-year-old accused rapist and robber made an unsuccessful bid for freedom in Fort Worth this morning. Robert Wayne Black escaped from Peter Smith Hospital here in Fort Worth about 3 o'clock. He made his way then to the home of a friend where he attempted to hide under a bed. 16-year-old Dottie Gall, who identified herself as an ex-girlfriend of Black, was at the home when he arrived. She called police after the youth fled with chains still on his legs in her old model foreign car. Within an hour, the vehicle was spotted at a parking lot in Haltom City. Officers moved in on a telephone booth and took Black into custody. The youth is accused of assaulting 2 women at lounges on Fort Worth's west side in late March and early April of this year. He is also charged with raping a 17-year-old Haltom City girl. Black had been taken into custody on April 4th and had been taken to the hospital here May 24th for treatment of a diabetic illness. Hospital officials say he apparently used a sheet to lower himself from a second-floor room to the ground outside the hospital. Black was crying as officers led him back into the Tarrant County Jail. Sheriff Lon Evans and Chief Deputy Earl Brown talked with the youth for several minutes before returning him to his cell. Sheriff Evans says he doesn't know whether the boy will have to be brought back to the hospital, but in view of the escape attempt last night, he hopes not. Jerry Taft, Channel 8 News, Fort Worth.
Why has California been such a center of this leftist activity and been sort of a vanguard, so to speak, for the radical left?
New York and California both, and I don't think that's any coincidence that this thing happened at Berkeley and at San Francisco State and then happened at Cornell and at Columbia. It's because we're the two biggest states numerically. And the SDS, which is the touchstone and the cornerstone of this whole revolutionary enterprise, picks the biggest states, the most populous states, the ones with the most problems. And the most populous states usually do have the most problems. And then they zero in on them and use them as targets. You have to remember that anybody can start a riot anytime. Your neighbors could go into your front yard tonight and start a riot. And there wouldn't be anything you could do about it except call the cops. This is what the universities are confronted with. Deliberate rioting and sabotage directed from afar.
Is the American system in general in danger?
Well, certainly the American higher education system is in danger if this syndrome isn't broken into, because a university, any public university, is not set up to unilaterally affect the change in the social, political, and economic pattern of the nation. It isn't set up to mount illegal and criminal enterprises against surrounding American communities, and it certainly isn't set up to serve as an ornithological sanctuary for odd birds.
Well, I will not admit that any so-called social problem is of sufficient import to revolt against decent behavior and to engage in criminal activities.
Are you distinguishing between protest and criminal activities?
I am very definitely distinguishing between them, because this peaceful protest, request to college administrators to meet face-to-face with students who, whether they do have or don't have legitimate complaint is beside the point. If it's carried on in a spirit of negotiation, I am for that. But what I condemn is a lawless group taking possession of the campus and making demands upon the college administration without any discourse, without any bilateral discussion or dialogue, but coming in with revolutionary demands and threats as to what they're going to do if their demands are not met.
Some people have said that this has gotten to been allowed by the majority of our college students to get to this point, because most college students, while they at this point do not agree with the real violence, agreed with most of the demands and the needs for change in our college campus. Would you agree with this?
Well, I'm going to say that if the college kids are that smart, that they can revolutionize the curricula and all college administration, they don't need to go to college. They ought to just go and apply for their diploma and go on and run the world.
Mr. Smith, we have your complaint on the holes in Bonneview Road, which we found to be cuts by utilities making connections to new houses. And these cuts have been repaired, as you have no doubt observed.
The Corps of Engineers have estimated if the Congress appropriates the necessary funds that they need to carry out their program, that barge navigation could get to Dallas by 1982 and to Fort Worth by 1985. It has been estimated that the total advanced engineering and design of the overall project will take approximately 3 years, depending on the Corps of Engineers' own progress on this advanced engineering and design, it may be possible to go for construction funds on certain phases of the project, of the navigation canal, as early as 2 years from now.